Namaskar and good morning to all of you. Today we will look at a small cap company called Kanchi Karpooram Ltd. Kanchi Karpooram Ltd, as its very name indicates, manufactures camphor, its derivatives, a number of derivatives are there for camphor, then rosin, gum rosin, and fortified rosin, value added resins, etc. Now Kanchi Karpooram Ltd is situated, again as the name indicates, at Kanchipuram, about 70 kilometers from Chennai. So strategically located. Now it has a proven track record for supplying quality products promptly to clients, including corporate clients. Its products are well accepted in the market for its quality. Now KKL has a high profile technical team to carry out manufacturing activities with quality and quantity consciousness. Manufacturing, it has got a very wonderful latest machinery, etc. And again, for checking of raw material, it has got wonderful team. See, the quality and quantity of raw material, so the ultimate product depends on that. Therefore, the company is giving a lot of emphasis on checking the quality and quantity of the raw material which is coming. Incidentally, raw material forms a large part of the overall cost. KKL has been certified with ISO 9001:2008. By the certifying body of Tuvsud South Asia Private Limited. Now, Kanchi Karpooram Limited is South India's first and the largest producer of a variety of terpene and paper chemicals. Terpene, that is serpentine, and so many paper chemicals also. It is keen to develop and expand customer base to provide industries with a stable, continuous supply of their raw materials from a totally new source. Now let us look at the type of products it is manufacturing. I will give you a list. Camphor is of course the main thing. Camphene resin. Camphor, camphene resin. Dipentine resin. All these are used in many industries. Isoboronyl acetate, sodium acetate trihydrate, pine pitch, double distilled turpentine, D-turpentine oil, pine tar natural, pine oil, pentaester gum rosin, terpene phenolic rosin. So the company is going on developing new products also, it seems. Therefore, we can expect the company to declare more and more products in the times to come. Now let us look at the latest results of Q1, which are quite impressive. The net sales are 46.6 crores in Q1, that is June quarter. The previous quarter, that is March ending quarter, was 34.1 crores, whereas the latest is 46.6, previous was 34.1. The June quarter of last year, 20.4 crores. So 46.6 latest, 34.1 previous, 20.4 the year before June. So year-on-year increase is 128%. Quarter-on-quarter increase also is impressive, 36.7%. Now about raw material cost, I want to mention here. See, net sales are 46. Out of that, raw material cost itself is 30 crores. Now that is, raw material cost also has increased 96% year on year, 24% quarter on quarter. Of course, net sales have increased much more than proportionately, therefore, profits and sales are impressive. Now, let us look at the profit before tax. That also has increased by 250% almost year on year and 110% quarter on quarter. Net profit is 10.1 crores, latest June quarter. Previous quarter is 4.65, that is less than half. And year before June, 2.7 crores. 10.7 crores latest, 4.65 crores previous quarter, 2.7 crores year before. The year on year increase is 271.9, let us say 272%. And quarter on quarter also 116% increase. Very impressive. Equity is 4.14 crores. It is likely to increase in times to come. Basic EPS is 24.23. Previous quarter 11.24 only, less than half. And 6.52 previous June. So that also has increased year on year 272%. Quarter on quarter 116%. Now market price currently it is hovering around 530. It is moving upwards only. I have taken the previous day, 530. Price earning is 5.47, quite low, and therefore quite attractive. Face value is 10. Volume is 5,898. I should say volume is a little low as of today. Let us hope it will improve, but volume is low, therefore at some points of time there may be problems in buying and selling. The price trend indicates that in the last 1 month the price has increased by 99%, in the last 6 months it has increased by 111%, in the last 9 months 308%, and in the last 1 year 740%. Wonderful multi-bagger in the last 1 year, no doubt about that. Will it be a multi-bagger in the current year? We'll have to wait and see. Now, actually, in the current year, it is already a multi-bagger, provided the current price stays 99%, already it has a clock. Now, if you look at the 2017-18 year with the previous year, we are omitting the latest quarter. Annual basis net sales have increased from 66 crores in the previous year to 117 crores in the current year, 44% growth. Net profit also has increased from 3 crores to 15 crores, almost 5 times. EPS has increased from 7.32 to 36.65 annual basis. Now, the company proposes to issue preferential shares to some members of the promoter group. That, to enable that, they are increasing the authorized capital from 5 crores to 7 crores. Now, all these things will come up in the AGM, annual general meeting, coming up on 27th September 2018, 27th. So, authorized capital is being increased and preferential shares are being issued to some of the members of the promoter group. Now, the company has recommended a dividend of rupees 2 per share of 10 rupees. That also will have to be accepted in the AGM. Now, some details from the annual report I will mention. The Managing Director is Suresh V. Shah, Whole-Time Director is Deepen S. Jain, Whole-Time Director is Arun V. Shah. Now, I find some general risks for the business mentioned in the annual report. We need to know that. The foreign exchange fluctuations may have adverse effects because the company is importing huge raw materials. So, right now, the rupee is depreciating against the dollar, therefore, imports are likely to become costlier. We need to understand that, which means if the same level of sales remain, the profits will come down. But sales may go up. It has been going up impressively earlier. Let us see what Q2, Q3, etc. will show. But we need to know that foreign exchange fluctuations have got adverse effects. Main raw material price by itself will have an adverse effect if it increases. Now, company needs to import that raw material at appropriate time. So, it requires sizable working capital. But company is managing it well. Company has been increasing its volume in sales and hence a better performance has come over the previous year. So, stringent cost control measures are there and quality control measures are there. Cost and quality control measures both are there. Therefore, the company is progressing well. There are some negative factors, but it has been progressing well. It is a small cap company and it is actually B2C, business to customer directly, and nowadays to corporate clients also. Hopefully, it will increase its presence in the B2B segment also in future. I wish that all of you listen to such videos 2 or 3 times. Kindly subscribe to the video, to the channel, and also ask your investor friends to subscribe and go through each video. I repeat a number of times, minimum go through 2 or 3 times. That makes your decisions better. This investing culture should spread all over India. Then only you will become a better investor. See, if there are more investors, the Nifty will go up, Sensex will go up, small cap index will go up, everything. So, you must tell your friends also to become investors in your own interest and in their interest also. The Nifty and Sensex are definitely going to go up, and that is the belief of almost every big investor. How much it will increase, phenomenal figures are being mentioned by great investors. And judging by the past experience, they are likely to be right. So, be an investor, invest well, invest in good companies and reap the benefits of development. Thanks a lot. I will come up before you with another potential multi-bagger or at least a very good company. Thank you.